Hello and welcome to a new session of significance of conjunctions or transition words in reading comprehension. You might be wondering why are conjunctions so important in reading comprehension? Conjunctions are part of grammar and grammar builds the entire text. So they play a remarkable role in helping us understand a comprehension. Now every author has a manner of writing and he does that by using certain words. These words help him to explain us how his ideas are moving. And these words are nothing but conjunctions. So here, in this particular text, the author has used however. However expresses a contradiction between the idea that he has already mentioned and the idea that is going to follow however. So it links the two ideas in a contrasting manner. Then we have the word therefore. Therefore summates all the ideas that has mentioned in the previous sentences. So it helps him to conclude the three sentences. Next he has used also and to add to the previously mentioned ideas. Therefore conjunction help us to understand what is exactly in the mind of the author while he is writing a passage. So, what are conjunctions? According to the dictionary meaning or the definition of in grammar, conjunctions are a word used to connect clauses or sentences or to coordinate words in the same clause, such as and, but and if. Here are a list of words that show transition and they do a particular job while they are used in a sentence, like words, moreover, similarly, furthermore, and, also, not only but also, add to the previously mentioned ideas of the author. Now, words like however, although, though, despite, in spite of, and nevertheless show contradiction in the two ideas presented. If A happens, then B happens. It shows a cause and effect relationship. Because, since, and as are reason markers. They help us to understand the reason, whereas hence and therefore help us to understand that there's an effect in the sentence. So, every conjunction and every transition word has a particular job to do. Now how do they differ? Now here I have two set of sentences, simple sentences. I like tea, my sister likes coffee. They are individual sentences. But what happens if I join them by using and? I like tea and my sister likes coffee. Let's take another example. I like tea but my sister likes coffee. Do you find any difference in the connotation of the two sentences? Yes, of course. The first sentence where I've used and as a conjunction merely expresses two individual sentences joined to express that I like tea and I have a sister who likes coffee. But when I use but in the sentence, I like tea but my sister likes coffee, it contradicts the two persons and the likings of the two persons. It contradicts that I like tea and it shows a different person, my sister, who likes coffee, unlike me. Therefore, they have a particular job to do in a sentence. Now let's take another example. Although Rajan studied hard for exams, he dash dash dash. You can think of something of your own to fill up the sentence. Here we can understand that Rajan studied hard for exam expresses a positive meaning. But we have a word although here which is a conjunction of contradiction meaning. That means that the second part of the sentence should definitely be negative in meaning. So you can think of some negative idea to contradict the positive one. Now I give you two options. Pass the exams with flying color and pass the exams poorly. Pass the exams with flying colors expresses a positive idea, therefore cannot be filled up in the sentence. Whereas pass the exams poorly explains negative idea and therefore should be taken as the proper part of the sentence to fill up the sentence. Moving on to the next example. Though the tigers are well looked after in the country. So here we have a positive idea. The tigers are well looked after in the country. Starting with though, a contradicting idea again. So you need a negative idea to fill up the sentence. Think of something of your own. You can say, though the tigers are well looked after in the country, their numbers are decreasing. Or they are decreasing in numbers. I hope you are getting it that words like though and although here are working as contradicting ideas for us. Now, words that show similar ideas. I scored well, not only in CLAT, but also in IELTS. Here, we have a positive idea. I scored well. I scored well in CLAT and I scored well in IELTS. These two sentences have been joined using not only but also. So you can understand that conjunctions also work of shortening the sentence and joining the sentences. And here not only and but also express two positive ideas being joined together. Taking another example, he is not only foolish but also obstinate. These are two negative ideas joined by not only but also. So two simultaneous negative ideas and two simultaneous positive ideas are joined using not only but also. Cause and effect ideas. The weather was not good. Therefore, we were not allowed to go for swimming. Here, the weather was not good gives a reason for us not being allowed to go for swimming. So there's a cause and effect relationship with the use of the word therefore. Moving to next example, India will win the World Cup because we have the best players. Here, because expresses the reason for India winning the World Cup. Again, a cause and effect relationship. So here, because helps us to understand a reason and an effect in a sentence. As we already talked about moving from general to specific, conjunctions also help us to understand how the main idea is presented and what are the specifics associated with the main idea. And for this, we use, for example, for instance. Now taking here, Felicia is a helpful girl. For example, she helps her father prepare breakfast. Now, she helps her father prepare breakfast details up or explains us how she is a helpful girl. My brother runs fast. As a result, my brother has won every race on the playground this year. My brother runs fast, therefore he has made certain achievements. Again, expresses specifics about my brother. So these help us to understand the general idea and the specific details in the sentence and overall in a paragraph. Here is a paragraph. Read the paragraph and figure out if there is a connection between the sentences. And when you are done, we move on. Now here I present the same paragraph with the help of conjunctions if, in fact, also, as a result. Now read the paragraph and see, does it make any difference in your understanding? Yes, of course. It does. Now here is a paragraph on plagiarism. I want you to read the paragraph and move on when you have done. Now this same paragraph has been represented with the use of transition words. Now the concept of fairness is central to understanding plagiarism. Fairness means being fair, both to yourself and others. Now, something has been introduced about plagiarism. Moreover, so he is adding more to plagiarism by saying that everybody both gives and receives their proper due and nobody has anything to complain about. So, two ideas. For example, so now he is detailing it with an incident involving unfairness could be taking someone else's work and passing it off as your own. So, this is how he is explaining what is plagiarism. As a result, concluding the previously mentioned ideas, the person whose work has been taken receives no recognition or acknowledgement for their research and thinking. So you can understand that the person whose work has been taken receives no recognition when people be unfair by taking someone else's work and passing it all as its own work. So again, it shows link between the two ideas. Furthermore, something more to be said. Writers who plagiarize are not being fair to themselves either because they are not developing their own independent academic skills. Therefore, again, summating whatever has been mentioned, students who do their own work with due acknowledgement of the work of others should develop their own academic skills and self-confidence far more than those who merely misuse the work of others. Again, the last sentence summates up the entire idea of the paragraph. I hope by now you understand that what is the significance of conjunctions in understanding a reading comprehension. So every time you read a paragraph, make a note of the conjunctions used by circling them or underlining them so that they are in your mind, and linking up the ideas which helps you in understanding the comprehension and come to accurate answers. All the best and thank you.